Hello friends, I'm going to do an open cup pour today again. My preparations are, I have a styropor soup cup, I cut the bottom out. It doesn't have to be done very properly, it's just important that it's not too small in relation to your canvas and that you have enough space to pour the paint in. So you could also use something smaller, like even you could cut a ring of a cup like this and use it. It really doesn't matter. I want to do a kind of autumn-like painting, so I will use a pretty dark tile as a foundation. Then I have copper, purple, another version of tile. I have dark blue, I have lighter blue, I also have yellow. For an open cup, I usually don't mix too many colors, but as usual, we will see where it takes us. In this dishwasher bottle, I have a premix for the foundation. As always, it's pretty liquid, so it really spreads nicely. To spread the paint, you can use your fingers, you can use a palette knife, if like I do here. You can also use your blow dryer. That really doesn't matter. As I'm on my table and don't want to splatter the paint too much around, I won't use a blow dryer today as I usually would. But I will use my fingers as I usually do, you already know that. But as I say, you can also do it with a brush, or you can use a smaller palette knife to get around the edges. That really doesn't matter. It's just about having the edges covered. So with an open cup, you sometimes leave an open space, and so it's even more important for an open cup to have the edges covered tightly, so you are not bound to where the color runs to cover your edges. It's just about being prepared and give yourself more freedom to follow whatever happens, because it's really annoying when some of the color went, or some of the paint went over the edge, but on the other left and right you just have the plain canvas looking through. That's just not nice, that's just not good looking. I also have some silicone oil here handy. I think I will take from one of the paints a little bit aside and add silicone. I do not want the entire painting to have silicone. So, and as you already see, we have bubbles. Our good friends, the bubbles. So the next thing we're gonna do is pouch the bubbles. And I'm popping the bubbles. It isn't really important that the surface of the paint isn't that even. It will level out pretty much while we do the rest of the work. And as we do with an open cup, I start from the middle this time. And so we need a small puddle where we can put the cup onto. And I think I will leave the bubbles this time, because when they pop up, they interfere with the poured paint. And I think this could be nice. So I will take some of, I take some of the purple aside. That will be the paint I'm adding the oil. As it's a small canvas and not that much paint, I think 5 drops will be enough. And I won't stir them too much. Just to get the oil a little bit into it. But for the first layers, I will use some paint without oil. I'm not really sure about the color combination, but I'm open to whatever happens. I don't want to limit myself too early. And you can pour the paint all in the middle of the circle of the cup you have, but you can also pour it around. You can make some small stripes, That's actually up to you. It doesn't really matter. Just the more you spread them in the cup, the more delicate your actual pattern will be. And at one point you will find that the paint is coming out under the cup, and that's pretty nice, and that's actually what we want, because then it starts to spread as fine as we want it. You see left and right it's running out, and we go a little bit up there. I leveled my canvas, but obviously it didn't recognize that it's leveled. It's actually a pretty wild mixture of colors, but I think it will work. So, and when you lift the cup, I prefer to move it a little bit back and forth, because otherwise you would have a really plain center. You lift it up a little bit so it really spreads nicely. Oh, here we already have a limp. You know these little guys. And so we start tilting the canvas. Now, as always, all directions. Carefully, and depending on how you like the pattern or not, you will have to tilt back and forth. Actually, I don't have a nice center I want to keep right now. We could have torched it in the moment before we tilted. I didn't do this at this time. I want to see how the paint interferes without it. Here I seem to have another limp, so I really want to see what happens without torching, because sometimes you get really nice cells without torching. And this can have a lot of different reasons. It can be the consistency of the paint, it can be the fabric of the paint. There's many reasons for that. So now we pop it first. Look at the edges. Is there anything you want to have covered first, so we don't forget it? Here we could use a little bit more. And now we torch. Now it's time for torching, so we can see which are just air bubbles and where there might be some lumps. And we also activate the silicone oil by doing so, and we will get these nice cells we want to have. It's not as autumn as I thought, but I think it's already a really, really nice paint color mix. So now we take our palette knife and have a look if we see some bumps. No, I can't see any. I do not like those big dots, so I work on them a little bit, like here. I'm not a big fan of yellow, so I don't want to have too big spots of yellow in here. But I think it's a really nice calming painting. So now we scrape the dripping paint off the edges. Never forget about this. And while we do this, we can have a look again if every edge is covered. And if not, we just take some of the dripping paint from the table and add it to the spot. So this corner here is pretty lame. I think I should torch it again. Let's see what happens. Because sometimes the second torching brings up some interesting effects. But I already love the copper here. And this blue and copper interfering here. Let's see if we can get some additional things going on. And as you already may know, sometimes you get additional cells while drying. That absolutely happens, that when the paint rests and the interfering really starts during the drying, sometimes the paint starts interacting again. I really like this one. We have a really small space over here and there where we didn't add any paint. And I think that's actually a pretty good idea, not doing that much here. I like a little bit of a negative space. A negative space can bring a lot to a painting. It gives it even more dynamic. So the edges are scratched. And that's it. The dry painting will be on my Instagram as usual tomorrow or the day after tomorrow. As it's a small one, it might dry really, really fast. I wish you a nice Sunday.